Yes, students, as we are continuing the discussion of fundamental unit of life, that is cell, and we were discussing the cell organelles, right? Now these cell organelles, what we have discussed earlier, that endoplasmic reticulum, about cytoplasm, then RER and SER, Golgi apparatus, lysosomes, okay? So this already discussed. And a little bit mitochondria also discussed, but today again we will discuss this mitochondria and we will continue the rest of the cell organelles. So what is mitochondria? Now mitochondria is a cell organelle that is present inside the cell, and it is very very essential. Like every cell needs energy, you know that you also need energy, but actually where your energy is stored, this energy is stored in every cell, and that is the mitochondria, is the cell organelles which produce this energy. Okay, now what is the, that's why it is called powerhouse of cell, because this produce the energy. Now energy in terms of what? Like kuch to hona chahiye. So that is what ATP, adenosine triphosphate, this ATP is synthesized inside this mitochondria, and for that the mitochondria has the enzymes, and that helps in aerobic respiration. Now what is aerobic means? That is mitochondria always acts when there is oxygen supply, okay? And that's, we are all aerobic, you know that, and that's aerobic respiration happen inside this mitochondria. Now about its structure, if you go, then this is the mitochondria outer membrane, and then inner membrane is getting folded. Inner membrane is getting folded, and that is special term is given, cristae. And these cristae also contain oxysomes, okay? Oxysomes are there, or F0, F1 particle, and these particles are actually responsible for this ATP synthesis. And then there is a DNA inside this, and there is ribosome, okay? So this DNA makes the mitochondria like semi-autonomous cell organelle, because this mitochondria can multiply itself and form many mitochondria wherever in our body it is needed. Like the flight muscles of birds have more number of mitochondria, isn't it? Because flight muscle continuously working. So this is the way how mitochondria multiplies itself. So that's why it's called semi-autonomous organelle. Okay, another semi-autonomous organelle that we are going to discuss is plastid. Now, plastids are seen spatially in whose? Plant cells, right? Now, plant cells have the plastids, and these plastids, how they look? This is a structure of plastid. These plastids can be of three types. This is entirely in plants. That is not present in animal. Because chromoplast, leucoplast, chloroplast, these are the three kinds of plastids generally found in plants. These chromoplasts are found in the colorful region, okay, and leucoplasts are found special in root, which is white in color, and chloroplasts are found in green region. Green region means they have chlorophyll molecule inside it, and that specially helps in photosynthesis. Now these plastids, that is, this is the structure of actually chloroplast, and that has got a membrane called thylakoid membrane. This thylakoid membrane is somewhere it is overlapped and stacked, and that is portion called grana, and this grana portion always bear the chlorophyll molecule, which helps the photosynthesis. And stroma has also got enzymes that is also helping in photosynthesis, but in the dark, okay? And the thylakoid membrane is making all this structure. These plastids also bear DNA, and that is also semi-autonomous organelle, because they can also multiply. So both these structures are very important for this mitochondria is present in plants also, and plants have an extra cell organelle, that is plastid. Okay, so both are semi-autonomous organelle, as they multiply themselves because of they have their own DNA. That is the speciality of this. Now what's the difference between the leucoplast and chromoplast? Now leucoplast, as I say, colorless. Chromoplast are reddish, brownish to reddish in color. And leucoplasts normally occur in the root, and leucoplast stores food. They are colorless, that chromoplast, they do not store food, but they are present in the provide the coloration to organs, and that attract the pollinators. Okay, so this is the major difference between the chromoplast and the leucoplast. But what about the chloroplasts? They are green plastids. These chloroplasts are green plastids. They contain chlorophylls, and chloroplast do photosynthesis. Now photosynthesis is a major function of plant by which they produce their food. Now next one is about the mitochondria and chloroplast. What's the difference? If you see mitochondria and chloroplast, what is the difference? That is, mitochondria occurring like aerobic respiration it does, but chloroplast, they help in photosynthesis. That's the major difference that you have to write. And mitochondria consumes oxygen and liberates CO2, isn't it? Because it's a respiration. But what it does, it consumes CO2 in photosynthesis and liberate oxygen. So this is the major two differences that you will get between this mitochondria and chloroplast. Let's go to now ribosome. Now where is, what is the ribosome? See this. Now when you consider that in a cell there is a nucleus, right, and there is ER, that is, what is this? RER. Now RER is rough endoplasmic reticulum, and that's because this RER contains ribosome in it. So, and ribosome specially helps in protein synthesis. What is that? Protein synthesis. So our ribosome are extremely small rounded bodies found either in the free state in the cytoplasm or attached to the surface of ER, that is endoplasmic reticulum, and is composed of RNA and protein. So protein, and inside this ribosome what is there? RNA, that is ribonucleic acid, and protein. These two components are there in ribosome, and these ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis, and they are called protein factories. Another this one is there like cell organelle, and it's called as centrosome. So what is that? Centrosome. And remember, the centrosomes are made up of two centrioles. So what are the things present? That's two centrioles are there, and they specially help in cell division. So we will discuss cell division in this session only. So cell division means centrioles are using, and the centrioles also produce this cilia and flagella. Cilia and flagella are also the structures that are present in the cells. So in unicellular organisms you can see like cilia is present in paramecium, flagella is present in euglena. So there the structures are also made up of by this centrioles. Okay, and now vacuole. What is the function of vacuole? Now vacuole, where we get? In a plant, there is a large vacuole. No? This type of vacuole is there in the plant, isn't it? So this is the vacuole. Now what it does, vacuole? What is the function of vacuole? So vacuole store the food, right? Vacuoles can be sap vacuole, food vacuole. So this can be of, again, three types. Sap vacuole, then it can be a food vacuole, and it can be of, again, sap, food, and then what is there? Contractile vacuole. A special type of vacuole is seen as contractile vacuole. Now, sap vacuole, food vacuole, and contractile vacuole. The contractile vacuole is present in amoeba, paramecium. Okay, there it busts out the water, whatever the extra water is there. Clear? So this is the different types of cell organelles that are found in the cell that we have discussed. Now next, you can easily write the plant cell and animal cell difference now, isn't it? So if you say plant cell and animal cell, plant cells plastids are present, cell wall is present, but animal cell, you will not get that. Then plant cell vacuole is large, but animal cell very few vacuoles are there, small. Nucleus is peripheral in plant, but nucleus is center in animal cell. So lots of divisions, differentiation you can write. Now you come to what is the concept of cell division. What is the concept of cell division? Obviously, here is one cell get divided into two cells. Okay, one cell get divided into two cells. So what is the cell division definition? We should write the process by which a parent cell, after growth and replication of its components, divide to form two daughter cells. That is called cell division, right? Now this cell division is of, again, types are there, and major it is of two types, that is mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis happens particularly in the growth, it helps in growth, but meiosis happens, it is the formation of gametes. Formation of gametes. Now gametes means what? gametes means the sperm and egg. So these are the gametes which are formed due to meiosis. Okay, so mitosis helps in growth, and mitosis happens in this one, like body cells. Body cells means except the testes and ovary. We remember this meiosis normally happens in testes and ovary. These are the actually in glands where this gamete formation occur. In plants it is different, and in animals, as I said, testes and ovary, which is easy to understand. And mitosis happens in all the other body cells, and this helps in growth. Now, as I said, what is like chromosome number? So chromosome number, suppose you have 23 pairs of chromosome number. So when a cell is divided into two, okay, that is normal cell division. So when it has got like 23 pairs, means it has got 46, and this also will come 46, and this will happen in mitosis. So 23 pairs is going to give the same number of chromosome. Okay, here same number of chromosome. So this is called your equational division. What is called? Equational division. But this meiosis, when it meiosis comes, then you know this meiosis, when there is 46 chromosome, okay, but this is going to give you four cells. This is going to give you four cells where 23 in each it will come. So this is of meiosis, and which is called as a reductional division. This is the major difference between the chromosome that we get. Okay, this is the meiosis is called reductional division, and mitosis is called equational division. Why? Equational means same. Same chromosome you are going to get when a cell divides. One cell divides and it forms the two daughter cells. So when this cell divides in mitosis, you will get how many? Two daughter cells. And these two daughter cells contain same number of chromosomes. There is no change. But when you consider meiosis, then this 46 chromosome number bearing, that in our human cell there is always 23 pairs of chromosome. It is fixed, right? But what the result in after meiosis? This each cell is having half of the number, chromosome number. It is called reductional division. So this, if the 23 pairs I am writing, if I write 23 pairs, then it is called diploid. But if I write 23 only, then it is haploid. So haploid is the one set of chromosome, but diploid is the paired set of chromosome. So mitosis and meiosis difference, what you are going to write, mitosis is like it's a chromosome number remains same, it is equational division, and meiosis is chromosome number get reduced, it halves the chromosome number, and from diploid cells we are going to get haploid one, but here we are going to get same, that is diploid to diploid or haploid to haploid. Okay, so this is the some cellular that cell we have completed, and any doubt is there, then you can clear in online class, and I'm going to ask you questions based on this cell after studying the entire cell. And so any doubt, if you have any doubt, clear in online class. Thank you very much.